How a voltage multiplier works. Warnings. The voltages used in the explanation are peak voltages, since a multiplier power supply depends on the peak voltages to which the capacitors are charged. In order to simplify the explanation, the current flow is assumed as going from positive to negative. While this is not really true, it's easier to understand by using this assumption. Of course, in the real world, electrons flow from negative to positive. This explanation is not a tutorial. In most cases, in a power supply of a certain quality, intended to deliver a voltage of over 600 volts, a transformer is used to step the voltage up to the desired level. Then current is rectified using a diode bridge, a couple of diodes for each alternation, in order to get full wave rectification. This pulsating voltage is filtered and probably goes through a regulator device to keep the voltage within certain limits. If precision and isolation are not that critical, you can rather use simple circuits which don't use any transformer or regulation circuitry. These circuits can be made by using simple diodes and electrolytic capacitors. To fully understand these devices, it is necessary to start with a simple halfway rectifier circuit, using a diode and a capacitor. As we said at the beginning, we will use the peak voltage values throughout the explanation as a reference. Also, for making explanations easier, it's better to use the conventional assumption of electricity going from positive to negative. Suppose a positive half cycle or alternation arrives at the circuit input. This charges the capacitor through the diode, making the upper terminal of the capacitor going positive and the lower terminal going negative. Now, the capacitor is charged to the peak line voltage, say 179 volts. When the input voltage reverses, the negative alternation does not go through the diode and the capacitor just remains charged. We have to wait for the next alternation to reverse the polarity at the input so the diode conducts again and keeps the capacitor charged. This way, the capacitor gets a pulse for each cycle of the AC. If you have a 60 Hz line, you will have 60 pulses just keeping the capacitor charged with respect to the neutral wire at 179 volts, the peak voltage of the line voltage. This is called half-wave rectification. This circuit can be modified and work as a full-wave voltage doubler by merely adding another diode and another capacitor, but with polarities reversed, so each alternation goes through a diode and finally charges a capacitor at 179 volts. And since there are two capacitors in series, both charged at 179 volts, both charges add up to 358 volts. This circuit is called a full-wave doubler. Let's now look at another very interesting circuit, called a half-wave doubler. To explain how it works, let's start with the negative half-cycle of the power line. The positive wire goes through the anode of the diode and charges the first capacitor. This capacitor gets charged to the peak line voltage, that is, 179 volts. When the AC polarity reverses, the peak voltage of the line adds up to the voltage in the first capacitor, so we will have a peak voltage of the line multiplied by 2, that is 358 volts. So far, we have already doubled the line peak voltage, but this circuit has another special feature. If we add another identical circuit, except for polarities of components, you can multiply the voltage by 4. With this, we will have 4 times the voltage, going as high as 716 volts. Finally, we will talk about a peculiar circuit capable of multiplying the voltage many times fold. It is also made with diodes and capacitors. It is mainly used to raise the voltage so as to ionize gases inside discharge tubes and for X-ray tubes. In this example, we will show a voltage tripler based on the sum of voltages present in charged capacitors. Although components are arranged somehow differently, it is nothing more than a modified version of the half-wave doubler. We will start again with the negative half cycle. The positive voltage at the bottom of the input drives diode D1 into conduction, thus charging the capacitor C1 to the peak line voltage, that is, 179 volts. When the AC reverses polarity, the diode D2 charges the capacitor C3 to the line peak voltage, adding to the charge of C1, thus charging C3 twice the line peak voltage, in this case 358 volts. When the AC polarity is reversed again, this time the opposition of the charge of C1 gives the effect of the charge of C3 being subtracted from the voltage stored in C1, since it opposes to it. So, diode D3 charges C2 at 358 volts. By doing this, the circuit behaves as a voltage tripler. This circuit has the flexibility of adding cells of diodes and capacitors in order to reach the desired high voltage. The drawback is that amperage gets weaker as multiplier cells are added. I hope this brief explanation helps you understand the voltage multiplier transformerless power supplies. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to my channel. Shabbat Tarin.